Hey, how's it going, guys? It's TechoSword. So in this video, I'm going to show you about the new BIOS updates that AMD has released, the AGESA PI 1.202. So as you can see here in the description, it says for my MSI X670E ACE motherboard that this update includes improved CCD delay and gaining better performance for Ryzen 9000 series. So what does that mean? It means that we've got a performance boost on the Ryzen 9000 series compared to the AGESA PI 1.201 that was released back in the end of August. So as you can see in the last one, they added the 105-watt feature improving CPU performance for other Ryzen CPUs, the 9700X, I believe. So in my case, given that I have the 9950X, I'll be showing you some performance difference. So let's check if it's going to give us the performance improvement they are claiming. So I'm not going to spoil things, however we are going to see pretty insane stuff. I didn't believe it, and it's up to you to believe it or not. Anyway, so first of all, I also want to mention that I have the AMD chipset driver, the latest one that was released in end of July, 26th of July. So that's the version that I have. So make sure always to update your chipset driver whenever you install Windows in order to have the best CPU recognition by Windows for your latest AMD CPU. So that's quite the recommendation by AMD themselves. And I also have the cumulative update preview for Windows 11 version 23H2 for x64 based systems, the ones that we have benchmarked in the last video. If you remember the KB50415087. So if you guys remember it, we benchmarked it, and we also saw a good performance uplift in that video. So both setups have the same update. So I have 5 games to test. First one is Cyberpunk 2077. I have benchmarked in 1080p, in 1440p, and in 4K, as you can see. So right off the bat, you can see that the FPS uplift is really huge, like 10 FPS on average on 1080p. We also see like over a 10 FPS average on 1440p, and also in 4K we see that huge uplift. Even the 1440p is now surpassing the previous 1080p BIOS version. So you can see that we've got a huge uplift overall, like it's insane. So we can see Cyberpunk 2077 on low is actually performing 10 FPS more than in the previous BIOS. Now let's go to Black Mesa Wukong, also set on low. Graphical settings, we can see that we've got also about 15 FPS at times in 1080p. We see also in 1440p, even at times we see a huge performance uplift in 1440p and also in 4K. That's significant. Like, I can't believe the much of performance uplift we've got in this BIOS version. That you can see in 1080p, we got 223 FPS on average, and the second place is the same BIOS version in 1440p, 212. We see the first AGESA PI 1.201 in 1080p is performing actually 208. So you can see there's like a huge gap, like almost like 15 FPS on average in the 1440p. This one, you can see that there is a huge uplift, 160 compared to 212. And also in 4K, between the new one, 190 FPS on average for 4K at low settings with RTX 4090. And in the previous one, it was 98. So you can see there was a problem. It seems that there was a problem with the CPU performance in previous BIOS versions. And now AMD seems to be catching up with this. So that's really actually a good news. Even in games like Horizon Zero Dawn, you can see in low settings, you can see in the chart, we got 273 on average on 1080p with the new BIOS version versus the previous one, 265. And in 1440p, we got 266 compared to 257. And in 4K, we've got about 10 FPS difference. So I wouldn't say, like in this title, we've seen some performance, like it's normal. It became like the normal to get 10 average FPS on low across all different resolutions. So that's what you can like imagine, let's say. And in other games, let's go to Metro Exodus. Here also in 1080p, we've got, like you can see, the same trend we've been getting across the previous games. We've got about 10 FPS again from 1080p to 1080p, and in 1440p, we've also got about, in this case, it was only like 4 FPS at most. And also in 4K, like you can see here, we've got very bad low FPS. You could also see in the video, like in the clips, there were some stuttering going on. I don't know. I have no idea why on 4K this game gets some stuttering on the Ryzen 9950X. Just like the previous CPU, 7950X3D. If you remember, I also showed you the performance problems that it had back then. Later on, they released dozen of chipset drivers that has addressed this issue. So we could also see in the future that AMD may release a new chipset driver that may address this issue in this game, like in 4K. I'm not sure why this is happening, but in other resolutions, you can see it's not the case. Because the final game we've got, which is Red Dead Redemption 2, at low settings as well, you can see that in this one, got the least amount of performance uplift. Like you can see in 1080p, it's 214, while in the previous one, 212. Even in the 1440p, we've got 212 versus 209. In 4K, like in 4K, you could see the biggest gap. You can see there's like about 15 FPS. So in my opinion, if you are looking to buy the Ryzen 9000 series, like the 9950X, if it's the CPU that you would like for gaming, you can go for it. But I would suggest that you look at the newer benchmarks rather than the previous ones. As more updates goes on, I'm sure we'll get better performance uplift, better performance optimizations, and so on. So I just wanted to share this news with you guys. Unfortunately, like this happened always with AMD CPUs, that usually when they launch, they have poor optimization by Windows. They are not performing as expected. Benchmarks are good. However, in gaming performance, they are not that the best. And by time, they tend to improve that. So we'll check if future updates are going to give it even a better performance boost. We are not sure, like it may happen, they may fix a lot of issues over time. So I will suggest that if you are in need right now of a new CPU, you can give it a try. However, you can also keep an eye on it, like keep an eye if it's going to improve. I'll try my best on this channel to give you always the latest benchmarks and latest updates about it. So if you found this video useful, as always, please give it a like and subscribe to the channel. Take a sword. And see you guys in the next one. Thanks. And leave a comment if there is any question, or if you would like me to try other games as well, performance of other games, you can always write in the comments below. See you guys in the next one. Bye bye.